We are preserving the craft that instruments had been made back in the 30s and 40s. My name is Mike Corrigan. People call me the Horn Doctor. I've been doing a lot of work down in New Orleans. I met a whole bunch of musicians, and one guy I had been really wanting to meet was Delphio.
I'm Delphio Marcellus. I play slide trombone. Well, I met Mike Corrigan when he came through New Orleans, and he said, you know, I want to make a horn for you.
I was explaining to him our custom horns, and he said, you know, I just bought a new trombone, but I've seen a lot of the horns that you do, and they're really cool. And he said, is there any way you could kind of bling out my trombone?
Mike came up with the great idea. You know, why don't we get you to play with some Kansas City musicians? So we have that New Orleans and Kansas City connection. And we're going to present the new horn, your new pimped out horn, at that show.
Now I'm excited to have the opportunity to have him in the shop and pimping out his horn. That's pretty cool.
So what I want to do is check out your horn real quick.
This is my baby.
Perfect.
You know, it's a good design, but I think, I'm coming from New Orleans, man. I want to have something with a little more flag.
Right on. Cool. Very cool. So then let me ask you, what kind of things are meaningful for you personally that I can incorporate into the design on this?
I live in a Victorian-styled home.
Okay.
Which I like. I love the idea of woodworking.
Right on.
And also a man of literature.
What kind of literature do you like?
Well, Shakespeare, as I like to call him, Shaq, he reminds me of Louis Armstrong.
Oh, right.
Just a couple of notes, and they get right to the essence. And with Shaq, you can hear just a couple of words, and he gets right to the meaning of what's going on.
I like that, actually. I like that a lot. Okay. Your horn is in good hands, man.
Okay. I've gave Mike my courtois trombone, and I'm anxious to see what he comes up with.
Bye.
I am literally going to have 24 hours to get this entire project done. Playing with Delphio's horn, we're going to be doing some custom engraving and incorporate a stained glass window into the back of his instrument. This is going to be reflecting the devastation of Katrina with the flooding. One of the things he said he wanted to have me incorporate is William Shakespeare, and this is going to represent the devastation of the Globe Theater burning down. And then at the center of it, you have the fleur-de-lis, which has a lot of powerful meaning behind it. And then you've got a horn kind of reflecting out of all the bad, we still have music bringing back the good. I got really intense and very intricate with the design of Delphio's plate. I cannot screw this one up. I've been here for 2 hours and I've got 5 pieces done. Got the plate done. Took a lot longer than I expected. So now we just have to clean this up, mount it to the tuning slide, and then Daryl's engraving the horn right now. So we gotta get going. So we're almost done. We're masking this off so we don't get lacquer on the glass. We're just degreasing the horn now. Daryl's doing some detail work on the bell, and then it needs to baked to lacquer be cured. And then after that, we got to get back to the shop, and we got to do all the final fit and finish. A lot of hand slide work to make sure the hand slide feels like bananas on ice, and then final wrap up.
All right, I think we're in good shape.
So we probably have a solid 2 hours left, and I have about a 2 hour window of time to do it. So.
Is that thing done yet?
Slide job. All right. This looks good. Yeah, buddy. Tuesday night, and we've done something that no one's ever done on a trombone before. I think it's going to look pretty hip. I'm going to unveil it here tonight.
All
right. Yeah, so Delphia, get to see it. Let's get Delphia. This is actually a custom stained glass window that I made. Never done it before. Delphi, you see that we put a quote, a Shakespeare quote that I thought is absolutely perfect for a jazz musician, and it actually speaks very much to the way that this gentleman approaches his instrument, and it says, "Have more than you show, and speak less than you know." Enjoy the music tonight, thank you.
Mike's one of those guys that's really passionate about instruments and working with the metal, and that's a rare thing. When you find someone that's really that passionate, I mean, that's the kind of passion that Louis Armstrong played with and that Charlie Parker played with. And that's a beautiful thing when someone not only has that, but also the craftsmanship and the skill to match. So that's why you see there's a certain uniqueness in the design and the way that he builds these instruments. So it's a special thing.